Hi everybody, it's Mary, and welcome to part one of my new Wash, Define and Go series. During this series, I will be showing you different methods that I use to define my curls. In this episode, I will be showing you how I achieve maximum definition for my coils, so stay tuned to see the method. Starting off on soaking wet hair, I work in sections to define my curls. This is my setting mousse of choice, but of course you can use any setting mousse or leave-in product that you prefer. Having thoroughly detangled hair helps the process go a lot more smoothly. It also makes it a lot easier to apply styling products. Any thick or creamy curl defining cream works well for me for this method. So to define each coil after adding my products, I take out small sections by hand and I wrap each small section of hair around my finger 3 times. This is a very similar method to finger coils, but it is not defining the coil all the way down to the very end of the hair. It's simply coiling the hair around the finger 3 times and then stopping. This method produces very, very defined coils, but also produces a lot of shrinkage. So if you prefer not to have shrinkage, you may want to try another method of coil definition, or you can also find a method of stretching out your coils or curls. This method is fairly intricate and can be very time consuming, but the results are great. You achieve really, really beautifully defined coils, and also the coils last for a very long time. I can keep this style for between 7 to 10 days and longer if I take care of my hair carefully. Styling time for this particular method can be up to 2 hours or more, depending on how quickly you define your hair. But in future episodes, I will be showing you quicker methods of how I define my coils. This method works best for me on wet or soaking wet hair, so I always have my spray bottle on hand just in case my hair starts to get a little bit too dry. On this particular day, I decided to do a flat twist at the front of my hair. This is completely optional, but definitely thumbs up if you would like to see what the final look for the flat twist at the front looked like. The hair at the very front of my head is definitely looser than the rest, and so I end up with some loose curls and waves towards the front. So this is definitely the 3C section, I'd say, of my hair. But the nice thing about this is that when all the curls are defined, it does create a slightly more naturally tapered look to my hair, even though I don't have a tapered haircut. So this is a quick sneak peek of what the hair looks like with the flat twist at the front. But also you can see from when I did the purple tint on my hair, this is what the wash, define and go looks like on my whole entire head. Thanks so much for watching, and be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out on future episodes of my wash, define and go series. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.